thankfully, that's for me.
It's week 11 of the National Football League. And up next is Darius Slay.
Taylor.
And they'll bring him down 1 yard shy after a pickup of four.
Good reactions there defensively. That screen was a little slow in developing, and they shut that one down with a little gain.
Sanchez on to punt here as he sends this one away.
They'll score that a 36-yard punt, and it will be Eagles football first and 10.
So back onto the field, here come the Eagles for their second drive.
And it's only November, but the playoffs, we know how it works. He'll be here before you know it. If it ended today, they would be the number one seed.
And that's a great spot to be in. But I love the phrase, if it ended today, and I guarantee you, that's what they've discussed in the locker room, in the meeting rooms. Yeah, we knew it would be if it ended today, but we also know it's not ending today. So they've got to continue to play the type of ball that put them in the spot where they're number one in the conference.
Second down, back to Sanders.
And he'll get about six up to the 27-yard line. Try and run for it with Sanders.
Yeah, this is going to be an Eagles first down as he gets it up past the 35.
And that's how you pick up a first down. Those shoulders went from parallel to square. And then he brought force with him to finish that run. Oh, that's impressive.
And we saw a lot of that a week ago when he got the NFC Offensive Player of the Week award. They'll wind up getting seven on the play. And it's second down.
All right, Charles, well, we've spoken about this offense plenty, how great they've been. We know now, into the back half of the season, they were two more fans without a doubt, and they get one of these on that. What do you think is the thing that most stands between them and a perfect season?
I think it's themselves. I think it's their team, how they approach things, how they conduct themselves during the week, practicing, getting ready, and then coming out and playing. Can't take your foot off the gas pedal at this stage. Doesn't matter if it's a weak team you're playing or not. Look, when I talk with one of the best golfers of all time, he told me he never played against the field. He just played against himself and his own standard.
And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He get a couple and that's it. The last run got a couple here, second and eight. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. The Colts are going to get it.
After the field goal.
I would say the feeling out process for both these teams, I'd say it's over, partner. Everyone understands what's going on now. You've kind of probed a little bit. Now you want to start throwing the big shots. First 3 points up on the board could be significant.
And Rodgers will hold on to this one, and it will come on to the 25. Second drive coming up here for the Indianapolis Colts. They are back down to the 500 mark after two straight losses. And Charles, this is a team that, to be frank, is their play has really dropped off the last couple of weeks.
And Brandon, I think there's a sense around the building that they can't let this losing streak get any worse than it is. Because if they're going to lose here and fall below 500, then you're playing catch up the rest of the way. They've got to take a stand and make it stop right now.
They went three and out on their first drive. Things already looking better here. First and 10. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready and looked for that run-pass option.
You get the sense the next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one.
Right back to Sanders on first down. We'll get this to about the 38.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out. And they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
Eagles on third down. 2 for 5 to this one. This will be 3rd and 5. Throwing is Hurts. They'll get this one complete. That's A.J. Brown. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. Hurts. He's going deep for Brown. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete. After the incomplete pass here now, he's 2nd and 10. They go back to the ground with Sanders. And very little running room there. He did get a couple onto the 49. 8th play in the drive, 4th coming, and they need 8 yards and 3rd down. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. Airing it out deep for Smith. And able to catch it on the left sideline with the ball rolling out of bounds. So the incomplete, and what they'd like to have back as it breaks up 4th down. And on 4th down, on is the punt team sending this one away. Rodgers on the return. 3 yards is the distance on the punt there. And it will be a 1st and 10 as they take over. Now Jonathan Taylor and the Colts offense retake center stage. So eventually now a 1,000-yard campaign for him, but I don't think he's going to take his foot off the gas pedal.
Yeah, it's one of those thoughts, though, that creeps into your mind because there is a little mini celebration out on the side of the team. Job well done, over 1,000 already. But guaranteed, as you noted, so much jumped in that huddle and said, a lot more to be done, guys. Let's not, would you say take your foot off the pedal? Let's not do that right now. But there is that possibility as people get self-satisfied. The greats do not. We'll find out what you're made of.
Play action. It's Ryan. It's incomplete. Couldn't connect. Here now is 2nd and 10 again for the 41. Ryan. They'll find Taylor. That's complete. He'll get only 3 there, so it leaves him with a 3rd and 7 ahead.
I certainly know that I, for one, would not like to be on the other end of a tackle when this guy's coming at you full speed from his strong safety spot. Boy, that was a nice play.
And I think really good defenders can snip out those screen passes. Just something that they can feel, something that they can sense about how the quarterback drops back or have a lineman just a little slow to block the oncoming rushers. He read it perfectly. Got in there and made the play.
Got it open, man. It's QT. He's brought down after a pickup of 5, but he needed 8. 4th down. Now it's Rigoberto Sanchez on 4th down to punt this thing. This is away, but boy, headed straight for the sidelines. And the punt over the side in the air, and the spot will be inside the 35. Philadelphia's offense ready to give us another look. And it's been very much a slow start for them. 3 drives and just the 3 points, CD.
Yeah, if you're into the points per drive ratio, that answer is 1. And that's not going to get it done in the game. They've got to find a way to finish these drives in end zones. Not how the ball's got through their place.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7. Here comes Sanders on the toss right. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. Of a couple on the play, so now 3rd down coming up. Come to the line here, needing 9 yards to pick up the 1st. He's going deep for Brown. And that is incomplete.
This is such a first touchdown this game. That quick 3 and out. That's not going to achieve that at all. Get picked into the secondary there. They brought out tight coverage on that 3rd down snap.
Here's Aaron Sipos out now to punt on 4th down. And look at this, it's a fake. And this is incomplete. A huge game on the end does not pay off. football in outstanding field position. So here are the Colts to take over. They lost two straight coming in, but good news for them right now, they've got the lead in the football. And this will be a gain of five as he gets it to the 30. From the 30 on second down, Ryan, the toss here completed to Pittman. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard
line.
That's on the tackle, Braden Smith. Temporarily out of field goal range now as they come up on a second and long after the holding call. Now Ryan.
His ability to fit it anywhere he wants to. A lot of quarterbacks do that and often pay the price.
And out now come the Eagles. Hurts and the Eagles come up here first and 10 at their own 24. He'll start with a handoff to Sanders. And he'll get this just across the 25-yard line. The last run good for two. Here's second and 8. Another run here with Sanders. Only a couple there as he brought down at the 28. They are in need of 6 yards here. They have to move the chains. Here's Hurts to throw. Sanders has it over the middle. This effort will not get it done. He stopped well short of the first down at the 29. Aaron Sipos out of plays to get this one away. 2 minutes to play in this first half. 7-3, our score. Here's Aaron Sipos now. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Rodgers to return it. A 39-yard punt will return to five. And they will take over first and 10. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. He rifles one, that's going to be intercepted. Picked up by James Bradbury. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to unnerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one? Or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
Philadelphia's offense ready to go again. And now they started bus territory following that turnover as they'll try to get some points here before halftime. And he's going to lose a yard or two, taken down behind the line. Quinny Payne. That is now two sacks for him here in this first half. 38-yard line, second and 11. Hurts throw here, taken in as he's able to find Goddard. And he's going to get this down near the 25. First down now, but that clock rolling. Again, running left, and Sanders. And he works his way forward to pick up 4 yards there. Second down. The run got four. Now they deal with a second and 6. He rifles one, it's intercepted. Picked up by Kenny Moore.
Penalty.
Time for the touchdown. Here's Blankenship kicking off.
this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback.
Well, the Eagles going to get one final possession in this first half.
And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guy.
It's caught inside the 25. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. So the field flips here as they'll go to work at the 20 now on first and 10. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have gone out. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jump that one free.
On second and 10, Hurts. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout. If they hurry, we'll see. So on third down, if you're going to come out, so try to get three before half. He made his first attempt, this from 45. The kick by Elliott is good. And a second field goal here cuts their deficit to 14-6 now. So as it turns out, that sack doesn't wind up costing them, Charles. They at least get points, get three of them.
Yeah, that's where your kicker can really come to your rescue because you know after the sack, there's a consternation there. We had a field goal range. Are we going to be able to get three? In this case, he stepped right up and gave them exactly what they needed.
So we hit halftime here in Indianapolis with the Colts on top. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Things starting to get interesting in this final weekend before Thanksgiving. Let's see what's going on around the NFL. We start down in the Lone Star State. Washington's used to traveling down to face the Cowboys, but this week they face the other Texas team in Houston. And it's the Texans who've got the lead in the second quarter. Brandon Cooks, a touchdown reception. From there, we head over to Hotlanta. Check out the Falcons at home at Mercedes-Benz Stadium. And they trail the visiting Chicago Bears. A couple of touchdown strikes there from Justin Fields. Lastly, let's get you to MetLife Stadium to see what's happening with the Giants at home in East Rutherford. And they trail the visiting Lions in that one. Two touchdown passes there for Jared Goff. Time now for a look at the next-gen stats in that first half for the Eagles. And they were able to have a little bit of success on the ground. The question will be, will they stick with it? Or will they be throwing more to try and regain this lead? Meanwhile, for the Colts, you get a look at what they were able to do throwing the football. And whatever they've done, it's worked, as they have the lead through two quarters of play. Final adjustments taking place in both teams' locker rooms. We're closing in on the second half. And to bring it your way, let's go back up to Indianapolis and rejoin Brandon and Charles.
Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. The drive will start at the 25-yard line here as Rodgers will not return it. And the Colts ready to go to work to start the third quarter. And Charles, they've got the lead. I would imagine the overall halftime tone was a positive one, but what do you think the talking points were in the locker room?
Well, there were three talking points at the half, partner. All of them were about turnovers because they were pretty loose with the ball. Otherwise, this lead could be even bigger. Now, I don't think that they overly worked on it. But I think they told him, guys, if you want to keep the guys in the you got to take care of the ball. Otherwise, you make the Dolphins back a little bit.
Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains. Six now, first and 10. Here's Ryan. Open man is QT complete. And down he goes at the 45 after a pickup of 9. They go play action now. Ryan. That's caught by his tight end, Kylan Granson. And he has another first down. Colts 33. Throwing again. He'll get that one to Taylor complete. And he is going to lose yardage here. Not what they had in mind there. That's going to go as a loss of four. So still 14 yards to go. Second down. Now it's Ryan. And it's running a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. To throw is Ryan. This will be swung out wide for Taylor. And he's going to get this to the 31, but that is still well short of what he needed. That one good for only six, and it leaves him with a fourth down. So Ryan heads to the sideline, and out now is Rodrigo Blankenship for the Indianapolis field goal try. From the right hash, this from 48. Blankenship's kick is good. And they will extend the lead here to 17-6. Picked up right where they left off in the first half. First drive after the break, they come away with three and increase the lead.
Yeah, you just want to keep building on that lead, don't you? Whether 6 points or 3 points, take everything you can get. Keep maneuvering, keep adding to it, keep making it difficult for them to come back.
And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. So here are the Eagles now as they get set for their first possession of the second half. And their deficit a little wider now than it was at halftime following the field goal a moment ago.
But the goal is still the same because you know they want to come out, establish a rhythm in the second half and get going. Make no mistake about it, though. Kicking field goals, not in their game plan. They need to get the ball in the end zone.
Throw outside complete. That's Brown. Hurts connecting there with Brown for the Eagles first.
Well, the obviously red man covers their partner, and he got downfield, broke down the defender, made him
what
think.
Do you mean by that?
Yeah, he made him think he was going to run a different route. Probably thought he was going to take it upfield, made a close back inside for the completion.
And the maneuver is way forward for about four. Second and six. Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. Another run with Sanders. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. 73 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon. Now from Colts territory, here's a first and 10 at the 44-yard line. And a pretty good burst right there as he'll take this down to the 33. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well. Up the middle they go with Sanders. Knifes his way forward here, but just 3 yards on the play. Second down. From the 30 on second down. Colts. Oh, Pascal able to haul that one in. And they move this all the way down to the 9. A good pickup there, 21 yards. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. They'll run with Sanders. And hit behind the line. He lost the football. It's loose. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. He has been a workhorse for them in this game, and ball security hasn't been an issue until that point.
Yeah, and let's face it, when he's going to carry the ball that many times, he becomes more and more of a target for the defense, knowing that he's going to be the primary guy. They'll just send more and more players towards him, trying to make sure they knock the ball free.
And now, as with every potential turnover, they're going to take a second look at this just to make sure. And the question, was the knee in fact down before this ball comes loose? And is the video convincing enough to overturn it?
A lot of factors here. Remember, you also need clear possession of football afterwards. This is a tough one to overturn.
So that one overturned. They say the knee was down, and that will not be ruled a fumble. Sanders up the middle, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it will go
sets up to throw it.
And this is caught. Touchdown, Philadelphia. A.J. Brown, a 9-yard touchdown, Brown. And the Eagles are back with it to score. Well, they had their chances in the first half, you remember, but had to settle for two field goals. This time, they come away with six.
I think they actually got affirmation about what they were doing by getting a touchdown, because the field goals means they got in range, but couldn't quite finish it off. This time, they broke through, and that's great for the old confidence.
But on the sideline, difference of a feeling between 3 and 6 is an astronomical
one. It can be at times, that's for sure. A lot of times, the field goal feels like a disappointment. The touchdown, well, that tells you you're getting it done.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And Rodgers will hold on to this one, and it'll come out to the 25. Now this offense comes back out onto the field. Their lead down to a field goal now as they start with a 1st and 10. Ryan. Got a man. It's complete to Jelani Woods. To the 35 before they're able to knock him down. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out by a few inches. That'll be a 1st down. Here's Ryan to throw. Looking for Woods again, and he finds it. Finding room in midfield. And they'll get this down to around the 47-yard line.
This was a nice example of the offensive coordinator scheming his guy open just to put him underneath him, just trying to free up some space. And it worked on really well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
2nd and 6. No, scratch that. 2nd and 7. They go to the ground again with Taylor. And he's going to get stuffed up quickly. Give him a yard down to the 43. And a line to gain here is the 37 on 3rd down. Now Ryan. This one to the sideline. He's got it. A nice job to keep the feet in, but he hits a bit short here on the 1st down. They'll run for it. It's Taylor. That's a run. Touchdown on the year, and the Colts will add on to their lead here in the final minute of the 3rd. Circle that drive, because that might be one to remember, well executed to give them a little cushion.
Let's take it into the box anyway. You talk about them commanding it, keeping the fight where they wanted to, whether it was in the center of the ring or putting them on the ropes, because it was jab, 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 and finally, the haymaker to put that drive away.
Across midfield to the 48.
A couple of 1st downs right in succession, and this is an offense that can really use a good drive, and they're off to a fast start here.
On 1st and 10, it's Sanders. He's going to be stopped here for no gain. And that's going to take us to the end of the 3rd quarter. 3 quarters have come and gone. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Now in Indianapolis. It's the Eagles behind on the scoreboard, but with the football here as we start the 4th quarter. He's going deep for Brown. And he fires one that's intercepted. Blocked over by Julian Blackman. And the Colts are going to get the football here at their own 23. position that they are in. Fourth quarter, two-score lead, and now the ball back after the INT. He'll take a shot downfield for Pittman. And they've got him well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. Now he'll go for 37 yards.
You think defenses might be a little more prepared for plays like this because so many offensive coordinators, when they get the ball after a turnover, they do like to dial up a deep ball right away. And if I were a defensive coordinator in this league, that's exactly what I would say to my defense before they went out to play. In this case, though, they didn't get the message, and a big play resulted.
Hey, they're going to work this down to about the 32-yard line. Second and two. A gift for Taylor running right side. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. Over the middle, hauled in by Campbell. And he is going to have a Colts first down. It's a gain of five on third and four. From the gun, it's Taylor. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up. If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up second down. Ryan. And this one is incomplete. They don't get the hookup there, but you really have to marvel at how precise he's been throwing the football these last couple weeks.
Oh, that's a perfect word for precise, because if you're at 70% or better 2 weeks in a row, you have a job as long as you're running this way, won't you? I mean, those days is not just West Coast offense either. It's probably
a lot of 50 catches for him now on the year. He's got a first down. Up the middle, here's Taylor. And for one of the few times here today, this one's not going to go anywhere. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
At the 19-yard line.
Now it's Ryan. And he's going to have the hookup to QT. And they've got this down to about the 12-yard line. This offense has converted two third downs on this drive already. This is third and four. Here's Ryan. And he's going to go down. He sat back at the 24. He couldn't get away there on third down. The pressure too much, and he sat for a loss of 12.
Rodrigo Blankenship on for the field goal. A 41-yard attempt.
Blankenship's kick is good. And they will extend their lead even further. So they run that back out of the line. As those are in the middle of the field, they're trying to swing their way in
the field. It's a big run until they touch down. He said the overtime does exist. But time, definitely a big factor at this stage of the game, is in their favor.
And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. So now, Charles, this drive, maybe a touch more important, trying to erase the memory of that interception they had the last time out.
Yeah, and everyone goes through this because even the best in the game, you're going to have games where it just doesn't go.
Hurts is intercepted, his third of the game. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And he will bring it back. An interception return for the Colts team. This defense just continuing to do their thing, and now they add on to that lead with another pick six.
And how about the way they played this entire game? Not only did they put their stamp on it, but every time they try and mount an offensive challenge, they find a way to thwart it, and multiple pick sixes. Oh, yeah, I enjoy watching this tape after the game. I knew they didn't tack down the 2 points, but I liked their attempt. After the interception return for a touchdown, I was thinking to myself, forget kicking it, go for two, and they did.
And everybody's scrambling. Maybe you catch the defense on their heels. They weren't ready to be out there.
Yeah, it's almost like a sudden change, right? There's a turnover, you take it away, they stuck it in the end zone. Keep the momentum going. Give credit to the defensive guys for rallying and stopping that 2-point attempt.
Now a dump off here complete. And they'll get eight out of this before being stopped at the 28. Line of scrimmage, the 28 now as they come up on second and a couple. Now a nice throw here right side. He hauls it in. And out across midfield down to the 45. They'll throw on first down with Hurts. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
I like the thought process there. They connected on a big play, and sometimes you find the defense vulnerable. So they went for the bigger shot, went for it all on that one. This time, they were ready for it.
And second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone and the frustration of body language is evident everywhere.
God, it hurts. And he breaks it away and falls down.
He holds such a big lead late, the effort hasn't lost one bit. If the offense wants to score some points in this one, they're going to have to earn it. These guys are not giving up anything.
They're going on fourth down with Hurts. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. The Eagles are able to convert there on fourth. And the Colts are going to take over with the football. The Indy offense at the line and set to go. Been a very strong performance for them, really, on both sides of the football. The turnover on downs, the most recent example, and now, obviously, they're in a great spot here.
If you're over on the bench right now, you're shaking hands with your teammate, hugging them, getting ripped out. Been a big, big performance for them. Now you just don't get careless, take care of the ball on the way out.
Second down, another run with Taylor. And across the midfield stripe into Eagle territory. The Colts on third down. They've converted three times and eight chances. This is third and four. Again, it's Taylor. And a strong run there as he'll take this all the way down to the 45. 120 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here. Running straight ahead, Taylor. They're going to snuff this play out behind the line. We have not seen that much today. Tackle made by Kaiser White. You know he can fly to the ball, and he showed it there. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Colts in possession of the football as we get you reset. And no doubt what they're looking to do is just salt away the final couple of minutes and escape with a win. On second down, it's Taylor. The second down play not much better than the first, just a gain of one there. And now we'll see a timeout used on defense as they stop it right out of the break with 1:57 to go in the ballgame. The Eagles call on the extra defensive back here as they prepare for a stop on third down. Nothing out of that one. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here. And we'll be back. So Ryan heads to the sideline, and out now is Rodrigo Blankenship for the Indianapolis field goal try. This will be kicked from the 42. It's a 52-yard attempt. Blankenship's kick is good. And that's the start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession. This one certainly has not gone according to script. You would have thought on paper that this offense would have its way here, but they certainly have not, and they trail big. After this, it figures to be a quiet trip home. Throwing again on second down, Hurts. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And he knocks the ball away and falls incomplete. So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to to the line and get him set.
Fake the give to Sanders, now Hurts.
This is Smith to the ground. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. The Eagles will take their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 45 seconds left to go in the game.
On first and 10, it's Hurts. Goes right back to Smith again.
And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. And he's got it. Touchdown. Devontae Smith. A 9-yard touchdown grab. And the Eagles have got it back to a two-score game here in the fourth. Hurts will throw. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
I don't know about you, but I can't wait for a few years of two-point tries. And see what the data tells us. There's a lot of teams willing to throw the ball in this situation, this time unsuccessfully. Just wonder if maybe running the ball might be the way to go.
With it moved up from the 3 to the 2, you can think maybe a few more potential runs.
I think stats over time may bear out. Be the equal of throwing in that situation.
Ryan heads down to a knee, and that should wrap this one out. So this one winds up an Indianapolis victory, and they were booing Charles by a big second half to put this one on ice.
To get the sense that whatever was said at halftime obviously hit home. I think it's a little bit more than that, though.